resounding the hymns of heavenly praises, the Santo Domingo Church is home to one of the world's most prestigious and oldest boys choir in the Philippines, the Tiples de Santo Domingo. Heir to 3 centuries of heritage, the Tiples recognize their unique vocation of singing for Our Lady of La Naval de Manila. To this day, the group has been faithful to the fulfillment of this calling, filling the Church of Our Lady with the sweetest of all sentiments weaved through the musical scores wrought by masters of old. A Spanish word for the highest and brightest human voice, Tiple is synonymous to the quality of voices of the members of the boys' choir. The Tiples de Santo Domingo was born when the Dominican missionary Father Pedro Bolaños started the tradition of training boys to sing in the church's liturgical functions. 4 centuries, the Tiples graced the musical life of the old Santo Domingo Church in Intramuros until the Second World War, reducing the church to rubbles, silenced their once glorious melodies. The Virgin of La Naval found her new home in the auspices of the University of Santo Tomas España campus. In time, it will be within these university walls that the Tiples de Santo Domingo will once again resound their hymns revered through the centuries, this time as the Escuela de Tiples del Seminario Central, trained and molded to Christian perfection under the able guidance of the seminarians of the UST Central Seminary through the initiative of Artemio Casas, once a student of the Pontifical Seminary. Later on, he is to be succeeded by Porfirio Iligan, Antonio Jacobe, Simeon Racelis, and much later on, Leonardo Legazpi OP. Through catechism and the teaching of virtues, the seminarians formed the boys not only according to the rigors of music, but also the following of a Christian gentleman. For many years, the seminary choir and the Tiples would sing as complementary choirs in the countless performances and important events, not only in the face of the church, but also in the life of the Filipino nation. With the sweet and angelic voices of the Tiples, supported by the mellow and voluminous voices of the seminarians, together, they weaved a story of a lasting friendship, transcending the differences of age, that brought them to new heights and prestige, having been regularly invited to sing for dignitaries and even for the President of the Republic. According to records, a Tiple can sing at least 50 religious songs of great composers in the persons of Beethoven, Bach, Mozart, Palestrina, Eslava, Perosi, and others, all by memory. In 1954, the new Santo Domingo Church in Quezon City was inaugurated, which prompted members of the Tiples to transfer to the new church with Our Lady. To this day, they continue to inscribe their genius in the annals of history under the care of Filipino Dominicans through the dedication of Professor Eugene de los Santos. The then Central Seminary Choir, now the Psalterion, went on to carve a name for itself in the landscape of musical culture. But what was once the existence of the Escuela de Tiples in the seminary is a testament not only to the Central Seminary's rich musical heritage, but also to her burning zeal for souls. A hymn most worthy of praise.